it's Vixie. I hope you're having a great day, and I hope it only gets better. I'm still gonna have to get used to the intro being different now. Anyway, this is different. Well, first off, I'm back to YouTube. Second off, this is different. I made a poll a little bit ago. My brush is still the wrong color. It needs to be black. There we go. I made a poll a little while ago saying, hey, when I come back to YouTube, what do you guys want to see? And I gave you three choices. Annoyingly, the results of the poll came back completely tied across the board, despite there being three different choices. So I had to decide anyway, and I felt like drawing, because over the entire time that I was, you know, doing Spooktober and everything, I didn't really have time to draw, and my creative juices were absolutely overflowing. So now that I actually have free time again, as well as I said I would make this a series, this is our first series of fucking Let's Draw, right? I don't know why I did an arrow like that. I've even forgotten how I do arrows. It's something like this, where I go, yeah, that's how I do arrows, because it's all one thing and it gets the job done. Anyway, I'm not great at drawing while people watch me draw. Like, I can do silly little upsetty spaghetti frowny faces, which I didn't mean to do. I wanted to do a happy face. There we go. Look how happy he is. I have never been good at drawing while people watch, so I have no idea if this series is going to be consistent, but I'm at least going to put one episode on my YouTube channel, which, before I actually get into drawing and what I will be drawing, I did want to say that finding a way to record me drawing in the way that I wanted to, where all you guys see is the canvas and then I have like all of my layers and stuff on a separate scene, which, oh yeah, there we go, I did switch to the right one. I'll blur it just for consistency's sake, but as you can see, I had to do something really weird because I only have two monitors. Well, I have three counting my my tablet, but I don't have a third actual monitor that I can put like OBS and stuff on. So I need to have a preview of, which I just realized I can see the preview. That's why I put the preview in the bottom right. Anyway, this super cursed way of recording, but I figured something out that works because I switched to my scene and had to check if it actually switched because I'm stupid. On my main monitor, the big one, that is actually my second monitor because I only have one HDMI port in my PC, I have exclusively the canvas, which is, you know, viewing the canvas that I'm working on my tablet. And then on my tablet, I have, you know, everything I would need to be able to access to, and you should actually be able to see my little cursor here. I can't really tell because the, yeah, no, that's there, I see it. My tablet, I have everything I need to, like, draw, like my layers and stuff, but y'all probably don't care too much about that, especially as it's just more aesthetically pleasing to just have the canvas there. Though, I do notice that when I zoom in and, like, I rotate and stuff, it doesn't do that on your end as well, which is a little bit upsetting, but it's not the worst thing in the world, I guess. Going forward, if you guys want to see the series continue, I'm sure I will figure something out. If you like anything in one particular way, like maybe you prefer to just have, like, my tablet so you can see me, like, zooming in and flipping and rotating and stuff, maybe that's something that's interesting. I don't know. I've never recorded me drawing before. But at least for the time being, we're just going to have this setup I have going, because that means I can perfectly manage everything that you guys are seeing without needing to have a third monitor and, like, an extra third of a desk, because my desk is too small to have three monitors in the first place. Like I mentioned, this whole setup I figured out is incredibly cursed, and I'm still not even fully sure. Yeah, I am recording. I actually have to do what I did way long ago when I only had one monitor and tap out to see if I'm still recording, so a lot of scuffedness to this, but there is some silver linings. Because I'm going to be editing in music in post, I can listen to whatever I want to, and also record at the same time. So I can listen to copyrighted music while you guys listen to the Hat in Time soundtrack, which is what I'm planning to put in here. But I'm not fully sure if I will be doing that, because it's yet to be determined whether I will get copyright claimed for it. This is a very experimental video in many different ways, shapes, and forms, but you're probably all, you know, interested in what actually I am going to be drawing instead of just, you know, repeatedly doing funny little smiley faces like this to make sure that you're visually stimulated, I suppose. So, as I mentioned, in my time off for Spooktober, I'm losing my ability to write as well. As I mentioned in my time off for Spooktober, my creative juices were absolutely overflowing, so I figured, hey, let's try something and let's see what all these nerds doing AI art are, like, all about. And I started fucking around with, like, Stable Diffusion and stuff. Which, first off, I will say, for the people that say AI art is real art, I would like to call full bullshit on that. And for the people who further say that AI art, it just takes just as much skill as real art, because you still have to, like, learn how to actually make things that look good. No, that's, they're full of shit. It's stupidly easy. Literally anyone with, like, any knowledge of how to type can make anything that they want. Especially now that I figured out how Stable Diffusion works, and there's, like, these things called LoRAs, pre-trained sets of data that people have made and uploaded to this website called Civitai. Which, wow, there's a lot more art stealing to AI art than I thought there was. It's not just the model, because to get the good results that people post online and try to fool people into thinking is real art, or just neglect to mention is AI art. Yeah, no, they had to go out and actively steal art anyway, and then train the LoRAs on that. So yeah, AI art is just flat out stealing. But with that being said, it is a lot of fun to play around with, and I actually played around with it quite a bit in my time off from real art, just to stimulate my creative juices in any way. And I've started, well, not started, but I've always had the idea of using AI art to get, like, references and stuff, but I, like, never share AI art, ever. Any art that I share is real art, and if I accidentally share, like, repost something that's AI art, I will just delete the repost. But I do use AI art for, like, beta testing character designs and, like, getting general reference for what I want to, because it's a lot easier to tell an AI exactly what you want than to scour the internet to find the exact, like, pose that you want. So I did that. With this being a theme of being a very experimental video, I figured I'd experiment to actually having, like, doing that thing I said of having, like, AI art for reference and stuff. I figured, hey, since what's something that I like, and I've been recently going through and playing Security Breach again, and I like Roxy, so let's draw something of Roxy, because that also might get some traction on Twitter and for Affinity and stuff. So, with AI art being a very high-skill thing that takes a lot of effort to do, I typed out a prompt, set the batch to 100 images, went to fucking sleep, woke up to 100 different free images, and picked out a couple that actually, you know, would work for reference, and I put some things together. So, actually, let me go over to my tablet here real quick so you can actually see, with barely any knowledge of how to use Stable Diffusion. Whoops. Yeah, I'll get to that in a minute. With barely any knowledge on how to use Stable Diffusion, I made something that looks fairly good. Obviously, there's some weird stuff, like, she's got, you know, 3 toes on this foot, 4 toes on that foot, because, you know, AR is dumb and stupid and can't understand stuff like that. This works for what I need it to, which it's, you know, a reference image. These will not be ever publicly shared at any point ever. Not on Patreon, not on my Twitter, nowhere. If I make AR art, it is staying on my PC, because I have a very adamant, very, very adamant rule about never ever sharing AI art, because it is stolen art. But I will use it for reference. It's a lot of fun to mess around with, and I pretty much leave it at that. I'm never gonna try and post AI art that I think looks good, because it's flat out stolen. And now that I know how Stable Diffusion work and how people get AI art that looks good, it is, like, double stolen. A lot more compared to what I originally thought. Anyway, you may have heard me smack my microphone just then. I have a pen display that sits on my desk, and my microphone's in the way. So while this whole time I've been sounding the way I normally do when I record, you're most likely going to hear my audio be more like this, because I have to, like, move my microphone out of the way so I don't smack it with my pen just by drawing. This is definitely going to be a very chilled back and casual series, because it's literally just going to be me recording something that I enjoy doing. So if that's not your cup of tea, then my bad. I will still have, like, my Let's Plays and stuff. On a whole, I do want to start... I should probably make a sketch group, huh? I do want to start, like, actually putting more effort into the term I'm looking for. I guess mixing my YouTube and my art, because I care a lot about art and I really like doing art, and YouTube can sometimes get in the way of that, because art takes a lot of dedicated attention, especially for me, seeing as how I have ADD and very potentially ADHD as well. So I have a hard time focusing on any specific thing because there's just a lot going on in my brain. Hence why I haven't really been drawing at the same time, and anytime I do need to draw, like, let's say we'll make another smiley face just for the sake of it. Ooh, it's got a cat face now. I have a hard time drawing and talking at the same time, as you can see, be writing here just now. I'm just gonna write what I am going to be talking about. See, my brain doesn't work like that. I need to like be gesturing and moving my hands at the same time of drawing stuff, because otherwise I get like confused and I start slowing down and I start like slurring my stuff, so I really don't know how this series is gonna work. Hopefully I will get better at that as time goes on. So let's see, of these two very, very fake images of Roxy, which pose do I like more? I kind of like the one on the right. She's got like her arm behind her and she's like holding a purse in her right arm, in her right hand. I think we might end up going with that. So seeing as how it has been a long time since I've actually drawn a full body, this should be interesting. I guess I should probably start with heads, so I have a general idea of where I want everything to go. I don't typically use, like, armature and stuff. Like, I don't pay attention to that all that much. I usually just kind of play it by ear, and if it looks weird, I'll fix it. But I do like to at least start off with height circles, proportion circles. I've never really paid attention to the specific terminology for these. You know, like how someone talks about a character being 4 heads tall, 5 heads tall, stuff like that. They're talking about like putting these circles in, the circle is the size of their head, and use that to like keep everything in proportion and whatnot. I don't use these all these much because I draw very cartoony and very often say fuck you to proportions anyway. But I do need to get a general idea of how, like, I want everything to be. So, just going from, would 4 be what I want? 4-ish, I would say. We'll do 5 just so I have some extra leeway here. And I find a lot of my characters end up being like 5-ish heads tall anyway, so might as well make Roxy the same. They're kind of askew, but they do what they need to. And now we'll put that opacity down to really, really not opaque. Oh yeah, and you can't see me like mirroring the stuff to make sure it's like off. Here, I'll go to my main thing. I'm talking about this. You do this to make sure that you have a fresh eye on your image to make sure it doesn't look weird from a specific angle. And by a specific angle, I mean it looks weird in the first place, you just got used to it. So seeing as how this is going to be a much more casual thing, as I mentioned, there will be a lot of dead air and there will be a lot of cuts because I have to think and I have to actually pay attention to what I'm doing here. And I have to like analyze stuff, especially when I'm using reference here, which is almost every time I draw. But this time it's fake and doesn't actually exist. And the only time you're going to see these images is in this video. So, I guess, let's start off with how I normally do things, and I do a general, like, shape situation, as you should always do. Do I start with, like, the... Yeah, we're gonna go a little bit smaller on the brush size, like, 30? Yeah, that should work. While I try to figure out generally what I want like the building blocks to be, I suppose this should also be a time that I mention that sketching is my least favorite part of the process. I find it incredibly frustrating because it generally is like the most like, I guess, creative part of the process. And I'm not really at that point in my art where I can just kind of go, we gotta do this and that, and then we put a thing up here, and then we round it out like down here, and you have a zucchini. I'm not that point in my art where I can just kind of make a shape and then it's like perfect on the second or third try, and then I make another shape, and then, oh wow, look, it's the thing that we want. That's not any specific shape when I do that, by the way, that's just me making a nondescript inorganic shape. Haha, hee hee. So because I'm not great at just doing it, I suppose, there's a lot of trial and error in the sketch portion of things, and it's the part of art that I'm, like, least okay with, I guess, just doing it. I've been getting a lot better at, like, shading and stuff, but the sketch portion of things, I'm just like, I don't like doing it. I really don't like doing it. If there was a way that I could just do art and not have to worry about, like, sketching something first, where I can just do line art, color, and shading, I would. But the sketch part is the part that drives me fucking bonkers, and it's the part that always makes me second-guess myself, and I start, like, being upset with myself. But then again, I used to not really like doing shading, and then I just got better at it. I'm still frustrated about that. I still took a break from art for Spooktober. I seem to have magically gotten better at shading, and that makes me angry because I can't pinpoint as to why I got better at shading. Because I was literally not drawing that entire time, and then suddenly I come back and my shading is good. And the part that's frustrating me right now is I can't remember how I did armature. So I'm gonna really quickly import a layer into my ref group real quick from... We'll do Vixie's full body. There's probably... I need to remind myself how I do armature, because I'm not, like... My brain isn't working right now. I remember now. I used to do this thing that I not took. Oh, I forgot a little bit to delete there. I used to do this thing that the artist RMK does with his very notable body shapes. We'll say. I know I do, and I say I did it from him because, you know, he actually put out a thing saying, hey, this is how I do armature, where he did, like, a diamond shape for the torso and then a diamond shape for the hips as well, and then, like, you know, did armature stuff around them, which I started doing that too because he's one of my favorite artists. I really like his art style, and his art style has actually influenced my own quite a lot. But when I was making Vixie's full body thing, I started doing this part where, hold on, let me switch over, where I would split the hips up into essentially three overlapping triangles, so you get like I guess those would be like hip dips, and hip dips make me happy. And I guess right there would be a hip dip, but you know what I mean, where you actually get like more defined hips, which it didn't really matter because she's wearing a skirt anyway. I do remember things being a lot easier for me when I started doing these three overlapping triangles rather than just like the one diamond shape. So I guess we could do the same thing there. We get like the groin-ish part, and then we can work from there. So she's standing kind of like, not bow-legged, but with her legs apart. We'll do like, say that-ish, and then they come back in because digitigrade, and then out like that. There we go. That kind of works. I actually am going to spread them apart a little bit more, because we stand wide hips in this household. And then for this one, we do the same deal. We go hip and hook. That'll work for now. There's leggies. Let me put these in a separate group as well. More separate layers I have, the more comfortable I am in the fact that I suck at this. The more I am doing this, the more I think about how the reason I wanted to start a Let's Draw series is because I can't really think of anyone who's done that before. I'm sure it's been done before, but I've never really thought if anyone had done it before. And if it is a thing that, like, rarely ever happens, and it's only really streams where people do this, I'm starting to see why a little bit, because I'm having a hard time commentating while thinking about what I need to do. Shoulder would be, like, right here. The other shoulder is like right here, because she's a little bit cockeyed. It's come down like this, and her arm is kind of going along in line with her hip, so she's like spinning like that-ish. Obviously, it's just, you know, armature, and it's not supposed to look good, but it still gets under my skin when it doesn't, even though it really shouldn't. What I do when I'm not feeling confident about the arms and leggies looking weird, and we will put them on low opacity. We will put them into their own group called ass, I guess. I'm not going to be drawing ass, but it's still part of a body. We'll put garbo, because it looks like trash. And we will put in different building blocks, and then we can essentially just have these as a general idea of what we need to do. This triangle situation, make it nice and sharp for the sake of it, and then just a subtle curve up here. There we go. triangle number one completed. Then we'll put that on lower opacity as well so I can further see what I'm doing. And now we just do this situation. E, connect it up here. It'll make another layer. Make it green because they're opposite colors. Then curve that up as well, like there-ish. Okay, we're getting somewhere here. So let's take these and merge them. Now that we have our general shape, and then we can kind of like shift and skew them a little bit until they look like correct. As correct as they're going to be, at least. I noticed I did a little bit of woof here, and I went too hard into triangles and stuff, but we start goofy, and then we work on that. There's an issue I found. That's why it looks weird. They're too like out. Okay, so we're really quickly gonna make our garbo go away and see if we can just go visually off of what I need here. Okay, I think giving the reference thing sort of like sketchy underwear just to get a general idea of like the shape that I'm seeing is showing me what I'm doing wrong. And what I'm doing wrong is making the hips too squat for what I want. Because like the shape I'm seeing here is like this diamond shape here, right? That's the shape I'm seeing and I'm trying to like do something with. And my issue was, I think, actually, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and leave that there. I'm actually going to, here, we'll go to my actual reference layer. There it is. And we'll make another layer for like my shape observation. Having the visual of like the actual shape I wanna make is gonna be like super helpful for this. So now with at least that visualized, we'll go ahead and go back here and let's try and do the thing that I probably should have from the first place and actually use the circle as some sort of guide for what I want to do. Maybe it's just been too long since I've actually drawn, which is very likely the case, and maybe it's better that I just actually find a different way of doing things. The three triangles thing definitely worked for what it needed to for Vixie, but this isn't Vixie. It's a new thing, it's separate. I can't just go back to the same image because that'll make everything look samey. And how do I learn if I do the same thing over and over again? There is a silver lining in that this is going to show any other, like, beginner artists or learning artists. If you're having troubles, don't worry about it, because everyone has troubles, and in particular, I have huge troubles with the sketching phase. Like, massive, in fact. Massive troubles in the sketching phase, and they often make me feel bad. So I guess, now that we're not going to do the three triangles thing, and I'm actually going to try something different, which trying different stuff works pretty well for me, I found. I wonder how many thoughts are going to be in this series that just go completely unfinished. Probably a lot, I'd imagine. Is this the day that I finally bother, like, actually going into an image and breaking it down into separate shapes instead of just doing it in my head? I think it is, because now that I'm actually trying something different here, and actually trying to translate an image into a drawing, with it being this fake image, of course, I should probably actually pay attention to like shapes and stuff, which I guess would show an issue of using AI art for reference and stuff, and that it might not be good and it might not be accurate. But just kind of looking generally at this, I could definitely see some weirdness to it, but I feel like it does what it needs to, which if there's any weirdness, I can definitely point it out myself and fix it. But for the time being, what we're gonna do is we are going to just break down the important parts to a thing. see, the interesting thing here, I don't know why I bothered switching scenes because I did want to zoom into something here. With going back to Vixie's armature real quick, you can see basically what I used to do. We'll go ahead and make this like a purpley color so I can like draw over and tell you what I'm talking about. With the method RMK, like I took from RMK, he would basically do this situation, which is largely the same, and that's very likely where I started. So he had like this, do that, there we go. He had just like this diamond shape for like the hips and everything, which I then expounded on a little bit and made into the like the three triangle structure I was talking about. The other thing he did was make a diamond for the torso as well, which I basically just directly put here, which made sense and still makes sense to me. For this specific like angle, it still makes sense to me. But since I'm doing more of a front on, I'm not sure how different that would be. So I guess since most of this first episode, I guess, is just me trying to pay attention and actually learn about armature and stuff, I guess we can try and translate it, ignoring the weirdishness up here in this general torso area, because it's AR and therefore fake and might be incorrect and wrong. I'm seeing flaws in my idea to use AR for reference now. I'm definitely seeing flaws. So I guess let's start off by doing that basically the exact same thing we did for the hips, which I'm actually gonna make on a separate layer since it's two different parts of the body. And we will just basically do an inverted version of the hips. Well, not inverted, just another one on top of it. Let's try and ignore her boobaloo here and just look like the torso behind it, I guess. Around here is where her neck should have been, but it just kind of is a mask because there's a scarf in the way. All right. I'm thinking too much on like the whole picture. We gotta focus on specific minutia. So let's break it down into even more shapes. So instead of trying to see the thing behind it, we'll look at the thing directly in front of us and that we're staring at anyway, and we will do this little ovoid shape for her boobaloo and the dress. We'll actually even go a bit further than that, and we will include the shape of like the lace and stuff that's like on the dress. And just for the sake of it, let's see if we divide. Yeah, and now we'll switch to a red brush on a different layer below that. And we have like torso here, curves a little bit because she's a female. And now, just out of curiosity, how would this work if I just like did the triangle situation for her shoulders? Not exactly the same, but pretty similar to my old method for her hips. Let's make the ref go away. It definitely looks weird. It definitely looks odd. But when I pull the image back up, you can kind of make sense of it. I'm not sure if it really even helps me, because at this point it's basically just tracing. But I need to learn armature somehow. You know, I was thinking just now about the prospect of like what I'm doing right now, and since I effectively want to just draw this and make it real art instead of AI art, I'm not sure if I would be okay with that, because that would effectively just be tracing AI art and then calling it good instead of just making art. So I think what I might do for this is just, I'll probably keep the like anatomy study lines I've put thus far, but I'm probably just gonna go with how I normally, like how I used to draw stuff, which is, you know, this basic shapes and general, very cartoony, not paying too much attention to specific minutia. I feel like if I just copy this directly over, it's not gonna look like my art, because I effectively, like, I indirectly just traced AI art. Stuff like this, this is why I don't like the sketch stage. There's so much, I have to do so much thinking about how I want to do things, because, like, I'm not great at art. I'm not, like, a good artist, but, like, this is the only way I can fucking learn, and it's really frustrating. Another thing I wanted to talk about with my specific, like, situation with art is I'm annoyed how long it takes me to make something because I have such a rough time with the sketch phase. So much time is just spent just looking at my canvas, trying to think of how the fuck I'm supposed to do this. I had figured that, like, this sort of thing I'm doing right now was gonna happen, at least, if not in this video, at some point, where I am now sat here thinking about how I want to approach this, and this usually always happens every time I do a sketch, where I am here doing nothing because I don't know how to approach it, and I'm getting frustrated at myself for not being better. Art is such a fun fucking thing, isn't it? When you're trying to, like, learn and how to be better at it and how to improve and stuff. It's a whole lot of fun when you doubt yourself and you overthink shit and you worry too much about it, when in reality, if you just did it, then it wouldn't be that bad. I've drawn things before. I know how this goes. I'm gonna start the thing. I'm gonna sketch for a little bit. I'm gonna be upset that it looks weird, it looks wrong, and I can't figure it out. And then I'm gonna come back tomorrow, and, like, nothing ever happened, and I'm gonna be fine, and then I'm just gonna do it. That's happened before, it's happened every fucking time I've drawn. I wish there was a way I could skip that part. And I guess the way to skip that part would just be better at it, but saying just be better at it is like saying, is telling someone who's depressed to just be happy. It's not how that works. So, let's stop worrying about me being trash for a little bit and just kind of do something. Can't have a video where I just sit around and be sad at myself the entire time. If I'm gonna be sad, I'm gonna be sad while doing something, I suppose. So let's just get what we did before and have our triangle situation. Yeah, now that I have that, I do notice that when I was talking in the, I think it was in the Silent Hill video, about starting a new series called Let's Draw, where I just kind of talk while I draw. I likened it to my Let's Plays, where I'll just kind of talk while drawing and not really, or I guess just try and be entertaining and chat with everybody while drawing. I haven't really been doing that because anytime I need to talk, I do that separately because my brain just don't work like that, and I need to keep these things separate. Actually, you know what? Hold on. I was trying to make a point just then, but while I was doing that, I kind of just did the thing I was looking to do. A little bit off, but there's nothing that a little bit of adjusting can't fix. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so with that under our belt, we have any progress, and I will take any progress. With that in mind, I am gonna really quickly look over to our armature studies on the AI piece real quick, and I'm gonna do that because I can actually, like, pay attention to generally how I want her legs to be. So, to the bones, yes. Okay, so for my Vixie thing, make this separate thing a thing for joints, because I like having separate joints. What I did was, I had like a, I want green. I had a separate thing there, which I just noticed this is on low opacity. There we go. And then I connected the two. So hold on, let me pop over to this side real quick. So when I flip it, so this is what we see normally. If you keep an eye on the green one here, I'm not sure if this is like this translates well to people who don't draw, but I think this can definitely be fixed just by making this, like, her calf come more out this way rather than straight up and down like that. So it comes more out this way. So we will try that. And the way we will do that, that's the thigh layer, we want the joint layer, is, and you know what, you can hang out for this part, I guess. We'll just go ahead and select our brush first off, and squidgy that up, and that's gone now. And now we just take our tootsies, and scooch them out a little bit this way, like right there-ish. That'll probably work. And then clear. And smoked our hairbrush again. And that's green. We want, or that's red. We want green. More out this way. That helped. I think that helped. Yeah, I still think her legs on a hole below her thighs need to be longer. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna take my whole ass sketch layer, like all of it, and squish it up. Which there seems to be there's a little bit of there's a little green doodad. It's probably almost impossible for you to see, but in the like the direct center of the screen right now, there's a little green doodad that I didn't get rid of, which I guess we'll ignore for now and I can just delete later. But we're gonna scooch you up a little bit more, around there-ish, so I can keep my canvas's like ratio and still be able to like stretch out your legs a little bit. And while I'm at it, little green boy, you go away. You're not part of this. But now, with my extra space, we can go down to the legs and then stretch them out just a little bit. We will see if that looks correct, I guess. Right now, I just want to get, like, the leg armature, like, not trash. I'm going to start doing that by actually connecting the tootsies up first. Okay, I think, at least for the time being, since this is just armature and it doesn't need to be exact, correct, good. I'm just gonna do what I did for the armature studies, and I'm just gonna put, like, a curve. Just a curve. And that looks infinitely better. See, this is the power of overthinking. I was way too worried about it, and I was just like, oh no, what if I need to do this and this and this and this and this and this and this, and I just overthought it. So now we do the same for this leg. Let me make the ref go away for a second so I can just look at the thing. Yeah, that's looking fine. That's looking fine. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna take the sketch and I'm gonna scooch it back down just a little bit. Just a little bit, like right there-ish. So it's a little bit more centered. And then I'm going to go back to the legs and I'm gonna see what happens if I just take the calves and below once more and make them ever so slightly longer. Just a little bit longer. Not by much, but just a little bit. A little bit. Just a little bit. A little bit shorter. The width is fine. It was the length that was weird. Yeah. The feetsies and such, they look weird, but that's something I can fix when I actually bother trying, like, you know, sketching and drawing and whatnot. So for as far as armature goes, I would say the legs look fine. So we actually did something. Good. All we have to do is figure out the chest up, which shouldn't be too hard. How do I want to do the hands armature? Do I do pink and blue like I did with Vixie, or do I just like flip the colors for left and right? I think we're gonna do pink and blue. We'll do that. But before I do anything regarding the arms, I need to have a chest. I need to have a torso. Go ahead and do that. Yeah, that's pretty much what I'd want. So I'm gonna have that as like semi-opaque. So I get a general idea of what I want, and I can just kind of draw over that and fix it if need be. Yeah, that's pretty much what I want. Yeah, because I want the torso to be like more like head-on, applied directly to the forehead. That's pretty much what I want. Because then I can like, you know, connect up like that and such. That was horrible, but it's just to give you a general idea of what I'm thinking. So, since I want it like almost straight up and down, but with like a little bit of curve, like in that direction, hold on, can make a bit of air than that. In that direction, there we go. Not up, but you know, I'm drawing at an angle here that you can't see. I'm gonna do it from this angle, and we have like our center line there. And then, do I want to go like this? Like that. Yeah. And then we can just fix this back part to be more in line with what we want. Yeah, that's pretty much what I want. So that'll work now for the torso. So now we can do the leg, or not the leggies, the upper leggies, the arms.
Which I will be doing with pink and blue to differentiate them, which I have already selected a little bit. This seems to be like a little bit brighter though. And for her, both of her arms actually, because they're behind her, we will make the arms group below the torso group for convenience sake. Now, I am actually kind of curious. I'm going to really quickly dupe my little torso diamond here.
Dupe.
And I'm going to invert it so it's more noticeable. There we go. And I'm going to really quickly take it down to our ref layer. I want to see what happens if I put it on the image, like see what it looks like. So let's check. We are doing a slightly different perspective than this, but I'm gonna see what it happens to look like. I'll flip it so it's actually like more in line with it. Yeah, with it being a moderately different perspective than, you know, this fake image.
Yeah, that works.
Okay, so I was thinking just now, that I've drawn and recorded a fair bit with most of the perspective being this first scene, I'm gonna explore a little bit and just try and have like all of the stuff, like you can see like everything that I can, see if it's more like visually interesting. So give me 1 second as I clear up this display and moving on over to the other display so I can actually like alt tab and stuff. Okay, now you can just kind of see everything I'm seeing, and I can actually like look at OBS while I record. I think if this series continues, this is how I will actually do it. Because now there's actually more shit to look at, and you can actually see me like thinking and moving my little cursor around and like spinning the canvas and stuff. Whoops, that's not what I wanted. Beep boop. So, shoulders. We need shoulders. Left arm. Left arm. No, we want right arm. Stupid. Being dumb and actually bothering with naming it after the fucking perspective. So, shoulder magoo. If we really quickly look at the thing. If I do undo. Yeah. Yeah, okay. I just wanted to be sure I knew where I was gonna put the shoulder before I actually went. Purple is right. Okay. So I would want it to be like right here-ish for like the shoulder situation. And more like we could put the left shoulder as well, like right here-ish. And now we need to like actual arm stuff. So we're gonna do what we did with the legs and do like joints first. So her elbow for her left arm should be like around here-ish? Yeah, and then her wrist would be down here. And then she would have her hand. Yeah, that looks about right. I'm kind of like, I'm actually surprised at myself for being able to eyeball that, like, relatively okay. And then, thankfully, because I generated a pose that could theoretically hide a lot of handage, we can go ahead and go over to our right arm, put the elbow in, like, the same-ish place, because it's, like, behind her. And then, not that far behind. Right here. Yeah. And then I can just hide her hand. That's convenient. Go ahead and go back here. And now we can make a separate thing. Why did OBS just minimize? Yeah, I'm just gonna do myself a favor real quick and go ahead and close this other. There we go, now I can close it. I'm probably not gonna switch to that other scene for the rest of this video, so I just went ahead and closed it so it wouldn't like distract me or anything. Anyway, speaking of getting distracted, I need to draw an arms. And if memory serves, I just kind of do like a really basic like rectangular shape, right? Yeah, that's the issue with Spooktober every year. And that is, I forget how I art. I just had a thought real quick. Just for me, this doesn't, like, do anything, but I am really quickly gonna... I'll do orange for it, I guess. I'm really quickly just gonna, for the sake of it, I'm gonna put the scarf here as well. Just, like, a general shape for the scarf, so I know, like, what I can and can't avoid, like, just sketching. That's, like, scarf-ish. That'll work. No, it won't. Oh, whoops, that's... It's a good thing I did that by accident, because I wanted to do that on a separate layer, and I forgot to. It's a good thing I messed that up just then. We want it like that sort of deal. A lot of diamonds. It's fucking Minecraft out here with all the fucking diamonds I have to draw. But diamonds are apparently a very helpful shape. And then we'll curve that inward. Wow, we have an approximation for a scarf that I am actually going to adjust just a little bit because I'm like this. There we go, a slightly different approximation of a scarf that'll work, I suppose. Move it up just a little bit because I'm like this. My god. There we go. Scarf. That'll work. I'm not messing with that anymore. It's not even supposed to be here. It's just I needed to put something there. So, now that I have that as a general reference point. Yeah, I was thinking just now about how the arm here is more at an angle than the arm here, but on top of the fact that I'm doing a slightly different perspective than this, I'm also doing modified proportions with her hips being much wider. Seeing as how this arm is kind of resting on that leg, because, you know, it's AI and it's weird, I need to have her arm in this one, the actual one, be more outward. There we go. That works perfectly fine, unlike my vocal cords, which are horrifically incorrect most of the time. I am gonna make this just a little bit more out. There-ish? A little bit inward. Yeah. And just because I'm really fucking annoying, curve the purse inward like that, because it's supposed to also, like, be hanging off of her shoulder. In here, in the fake image, you can see the AI didn't really know what to do here. I just typed in holding purse. So, she was like, just put, like, a shape there, and there she's holding something, woohoo, because you know how AIs work. But in my actual drawing, I do want her to go to white. I want her to be holding this purse right here, and I want her to have, like, the strap coming down, and then also, like, connecting to it, if that makes any sense. I want there to be, like, a visible strap where, like, it's not necessarily a purse, but, like, an evening bag, you know? Because, the whole idea behind this drawing was, you're on a date with Roxy, because, wife. But, trying to get a reference from an AI for that was a little bit, Whereas, I feel like if I just did the normal thing of, looking up reference of Roxanne Wolf and separate pictures of a pretty lady wearing a dress out on a date, that probably would have been better, but I had my reasons for doing AI art for reference. And I feel like doing anything good with AI art is a bonus, because most of the time, it's just used to steal art. So I felt better using AI art for a force of good, which is to say, reference. All right, now for the left arm. I I don't want to, like, go too far into this, because then it would look like she's scratching her ass, which that's not what that's supposed to be. I would say that looks fine enough for just, you know, something that is going to be almost entirely covered up. All right, so now we have torso, hip. Wow. You could tell I haven't recorded in a while. That was a spicy voice crack. So now that we have torso, hips, legs, and arms, and some pointless scarfage and pursage, now we need a noggin, which should be interesting. I don't have much experience drawing at, like, this angle, but it's still going to be, like, three-quarters-ish. The interesting thing is going to be drawing eyes that aren't covered, which I have done before. I did pretty okay, but I'm not great at. I prefer the hair over eye look, because it means slightly less work as far as detailing the face goes. Even here, I tried to get the AI to generate the hair over the eye, and it was like, categorically that is over the eye, but it's not covering that eye. So I think I'll stop avoiding drawing two eyes and actually figure it out. Which, I just had a thought real quick, give me 1 second. I'm just gonna have some motivation from one of my favorite thumbnails I've drawn, just as a reminder that I can draw stuff that doesn't suck. And also, this is like the other time I drew something where, you know, both eyes were visible, which I don't really do. So there's a point for having Empress be here, aside from just kind of, you know, being here. Seeing as how I'm basically shifting the perspective where instead of being more head-on and she's facing this way, I have her more turned to her left and facing this way, this isn't gonna really work. So now the question is, what shape I want to use as like a base shape, because I could go for the circle situation and go off of there, but I almost always ignore that. Hold on, let me see if I can pull up an example real quick of when I drew like Vixie or something. I'm just gonna really quickly open up the... Yeah, this is a very early, like, sketchy checkpoint situation, as you can tell from the name. So let me really quickly go to the... Where's my... spine and such? Oh, wait, no, I have, like, erasure masks. Hold on. Oh, right, it wasn't erasure... I hadn't been doing erasure masks yet, but, oh, no, I kind of... Yeah, I guess I actually did pay attention to the head circle this time around. Wow, usually I don't bother. No wonder this fucking picture of Vixie actually came out looking like good. Huh. You actually pay attention, I guess it works perfectly fine. No. Okay, anyway, back to this. So, I guess, with that in mind, we'll go ahead and make our circle, I suppose. And now we get to do the fun thing of doing a thing that makes circles for me, because I can't do that. The scarf being there is a great resource. Yeah, there we go. Now she's kind of looking at the camera. Just, oh my god, with my reference group being, like, all of them being visible, it's so fucking hectic. Hold on, let's make that go away. There we go, clean slate. Look at how, like, less chaotic this is. I say with each limb being a different fucking color. Am I the only person who does this, by the way? Genuinely, any artists in the comments, like, skilled, experienced, beginner, professional, whatever, anyone who happens to be watching this and is an artist, do you separate your limbs into different colors so you know which one is which? Of, like, art tutorials and stuff I've seen, or just, like, other sketches that people have posted, I have seen people use, like, red for bodies and then, like, blues for limbs, but nothing ever, they're not, like, Technicolor before. I'm the only person I've seen, like, do that. I'm actually gonna clean up my ref thing real quick. This one I'm not really paying attention to. Empress stays. She can hang out, like, she'll hang out where that was. There we go. And because I'm right-handed and I don't want to be working at a super weird angle for the fact that I'm right-handed, I should probably learn how to, like, draw faces facing that way. Because I almost always draw faces facing that way. as you can tell by almost anything I have ever drawn at any point ever, their face is always headed in that direction and never the opposite one. So I should probably learn how to, like, draw separate perspectives as far as, like, where people are facing goes, but I'm not too concerned with that right now, because I've already had to deal with sketching all of this nonsense up. Which, now that I'm looking at the arms, are looking a little bit iffy, but we're not doing the arms right now. We need to do, like, face situation. We'll do 25% opacity. I'm gonna make these even less opaque, like 5%. They're not really doing a whole lot. I'm only half paying attention to them. I could do what I normally do and draw the hair first and draw the face around it. But seeing as how I'm probably gonna end up drawing like the eyes, maybe I will start with the eyes because I haven't started drawing a face with the eyes in a while. You know, I should start drawing with the eyes more often because that like looks okay, like immediately. Hold on, let's do my favorite part of drawing eyes and just like give him just makeup real quick just to see. Yeah, no, this kind of looks fine. Am I crazy? Did I just like do the eyes like immediately? Am I bonkers? Am I insane? I feel like I'm bonkers because I don't do things the first try. I do need to like adjust them a little bit because I feel like they're too big. Yeah, just looking at waifu number two over here and comparing her to like where the face is going to be on here. Actually, they need to be a little bit smaller. A little bit smaller. And just for, you know, posterity's sake of mentioning everything that's wrong with this, this one's just the makeup's a little bit wrong, but on a whole, the eyes need to be a little bit smaller. Apparently, if there's one thing I'm good at actually just doing is eyes. Go figure. It's almost like I absolutely love drawing eyes purely because drawing makeup is incredibly satisfying to me, which is why, like, all of my OCs with lips are wearing lipstick. So now that I just have eyes, just erase the makeup, so just I have eyes. Would they be almond-shaped? Like actually almond-shaped? Normally, when I draw eyes, they're like this. Like that kind of shape, right? Where they're kind of almond-shaped, but like there's a defined like separation here, where they're much taller than they are like wide, I guess? But I had a thought just now looking at like this little eye here with like the separation between like where the eye is and where the mascara is. And I'm kind of curious what would happen if I basically took what I normally do, but actually like have them come back around and meet. So I think to try that out, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this here and just kind of adjust it so it comes to a point like that. Oop, too big. Yeah. Kind of a neat shape for an eye. Okay, so just with the eyes, I'm gonna come back to the eyes that I just put there as like as filler real quick. Now that I actually have them there in like the actual perspective that the image is going to be with her facing this way specifically, I kind of really like that. I think I did really good. Cool. Those eyes I'm gonna keep. Cause I'm still surprised I did that so like easily. But I am gonna make them a little bit opaque, and I'm going to experiment. Yeah, maybe it's just because I made the other eye look a little bit off. I'm not really vibing with the almond-shaped eyes. Might just go with what I normally go with. Yeah, I just kind of nailed it on this first go-around. This is kind of good. It's just, like, correct. So I might just trace over this, and those will be my eyes, and I'll probably end up making the makeup more detailed and have, like, more visible eyelashes and stuff. Thank you. say that works. That works for what we need it to. And I find a lot of the time when I'm like drawing the face paste, let's look over at Empress real quick. When I'm drawing faces, I find myself always like over-exaggerating the size of like the eyes compared to the rest of the facial features. So a lot of the time I will like physically draw everything else, go back to the eyes and like flip it and stuff like this. I will flip and see, oh, is that weird? Is it weird? Is it weird? And then I will take the eye and like morph it around and see if I can get it to look better, whether it's smaller, bigger, or just like a slightly different shape on a whole. So with that in mind, I will probably be coming back to the eyes and like making them a bit more probably smaller, most likely smaller. I'm not sure. We will see. So now we get to draw. I feel like the muzzle, her muzzle is probably the best idea for me to start with. So I guess a good way to start with this is just... I don't know why I find that so funny. Oh, my stabilizer wasn't turned on. That's why. Okay. Yeah. I don't have too steady a hand, so I need to, like, have this stabilizer on to at least a 100 sample count. Hmm. Okay. Maybe, like, her jowls aren't the best idea. So what if we do... We just do, like, the snoot. So we'll do, like, that situation. And then downy. And then uppy. Like that. Like a little bit more like that. Farther out like that. And then there we go. That'll work. And then we can move that around and see where we want her snoot to be. There's the snoot. Do I want to bother with a separate layer? I should probably bother with a separate layer. It'll save me some grief going forward. Okay, so we have the snoot. And she does indeed have the jowl situation. Yeah, looking at it from both angles, that is how I want the nose to be. So I just need to do like her muzzle look better. Which I could just like the muzzle actually looks so, like shockingly good on the generated image, which usually because I like to specify like the black lips that I typically draw, where it's like that defined bottom lip and it's usually like pitch black. Because I specify that in the prompts that I use, usually it, like, doesn't know what to do with, because that's... Other artists do that, but it's a lot less common than just mouth, like, normal muzzle. So I could just go straight off of that, which I think what my issue is, I'm going too hard into, like, the cat face, like this, where it just looks, like, a little bit weird. That's my issue. Because if we look at this one, we can see, like... Damn it. We can see, like, yeah, that's weirdly good. Like, AI art scares me with how, like, good that muzzle is. That's definitely stolen directly from something. But, let's see. Yeah, okay. So let me do just this so we have a notable thing. There we go. So we have, like, it coming down around like that. And then where I am coming directly from, like, that snout line... It's looking like this had it be where it's just kind of that one this one continuous shape here, which I'm mapping out in a really cursed way, but you see what I mean, right? It's just like this one continuous shape, as opposed to what I was doing where I was separating it at the nose line. So we might end up doing that. Yeah, that looks much better. Obviously still wrong, because, you know, it's just a sketch and it's not supposed to be perfect, but if I just do, like, that situation... I don't know why, but with, this specific, what I have here, my brain was like, Garfield. Yeah, I think... Oh, too big. I think what I'm gonna end up doing is... I feel like I did this, like, the right side pretty okay. Have that connect more that way. Come back around and then we'll... Yeah, basically that, but yeah, that doesn't look great. Yeah, I think I'm gonna really quickly grab her, like the face from her full body just as a reference, because the angle is pretty similar where she's looking like down and then like peeking up at you. It is going to be different because Pixie's a coyote and Roxanne is a wolf. but this does give me a general idea of how I draw muzzles. And Roxy is looking more at the camera than Vixie does. And we'll keep her here, just as a supporty situation. Here, smell my tail. Delicious. Smells like vanilla. Put her up by Empress, just to make myself happy. Oh, actually, you know what? I did remember that time I drew Freya, but like goth Freya, because of course I did. That's another time where, like, I drew an actual, like, muzzle. So I'm gonna pull that up as well. It's old, and you can tell that I went with more of a stylized, weird shape approach, because Burmesians have weird head shapes. Alright, well, thank you, Goth, for... But I'm still, like, very satisfied with this. Hold on. I just wanna look at this real quick, because, like, the shading is, like, not great, and her feet are, like, awful, but, like, I still like this. I still like this a whole lot. This gives me hope for this Roxy drawing I'm doing, because apparently when I draw one of my waifus, then it actually comes out really good. And since I'm drawing this with my new weird talent of shading, this would actually, like, be, like, even better. Cool. I might at least draw her hair flap, just so I have another, like, quote-unquote facial feature to work off of. Okay, I'm back. That was, a little bit unexpected, but I apparently received an early Christmas present in the mail from a good friend of mine, so I now have a dedicated hard drive for all of the insane amount of footage that I regularly have, so thanks, Dread, that's very much appreciated. Right, I was trying to decide which side of her face I want her hair flap to be, and I was talking about how her official design and, like, renders and stuff, and, like, her in-game, Roxy's hair flap is going over her left eye, unlike Vixie's, who is going over her right eye. So, if I'm going to be at least 10% on model with this, I'm gonna need to have her hair flap going over like that. But, like, you know, good. Probably, like, worry about, like, specific hair details, and minutia is the word of the day, boys. We'll make it a little bit bigger, but not, like, too big. It needs to be, like, more... I don't want to cover her eye fully, because I don't want to just do hair over eye like I always do. What I might end up doing is, like, her cheek fluff, because I remember I did that with Vixie. What I did, basically, was... I did her hair situation first, which is basically just always like this, and then I did her cheek fluff, which is like that, and then I connected it around, but I could only really do that when I had, like, her mouth, so I just kind of had floating cheek fluff for a little bit. So I might end up doing the same thing here, but with Roxy. I was thinking about sort of doing it in, like, a similar way to, like, Lycanroc, because, you know, that's another wolf, like, where it kind of curves down like that, and then it, like, goes up, sort of like that. She's looking, with how simple it is right now, she's looking like a fucking Animal Crossing character, and I kind of love that, but that's basically what I want to do. So we're actually gonna go ahead and commit to that. Roxy doesn't have canon cheek fluff because, her being an animatronic and plasticky, her head is kind of round. So it's really dealer's choice for how I want to end up doing this. Yeah. Because of the way her hair is, most people interpret it almost like the, like, half-shaved head style. Sort of, like, even in this AI image, it interpreted it as, like, that sort of half-shaved head style, where she has long hair and hair over this eye, but she doesn't have any more bangs over here. Which is, funnily enough, the opposite of what- where'd she go? Right, Vixie's over here. Which, Vixie has, like, full bangs, like, hair all the way, hairs for days. But Roxy doesn't have that, so Most people, and apparently robots as well, also interpret it as like that half-shaved style, which I might do the same. I'm not huge on that style. I'm not huge on shaved heads, period. But it really works for Roxy, so I might end up doing that as well. We will see. But right now, I really want to figure out this cheek fluff situation. So, since I have that general shape, kind of works a little bit. All right, let's stick with that idea. Connect it up like that. Then we'll actually have this come out more and separate them even more. All right, structure go away. Let's see how that looks. Yeah, actually, it's kind of cat looking, but I feel like that'll change when I actually get around to like drawing her ears and stuff, and it's gonna make them wolf-like. And now we can try and figure out how we want to do her muzzle once again. Just out of curiosity, what if I like did like fully on model lips? Yeah, no, that's not my style. We're not doing that. And then do that. And then do I want to go inward or outward? In or out? I'm gonna do in first. And then do that. Curve around a bit more. Go a bit more up this time, and then we have the like the split. That looks a bit better. She still looks a bit too much like an Animal Crossing character. Do I just draw Animal Crossing characters? Is that what I'm seeing here? That would be an interesting revelation. But I actually do see a way I could potentially make this look better, and it just involves doing this, roughly. That-ish. Let's make the ref muzzle go away. Alright, hold on. Let's do that whole thing again, but with the ref gone. Okay, and then move that up a little bit. Then deselect. Whoops, wrong one. And come through here, up. Then we connect it. How's that look? For sure, with a nose, that would be better. Hold on. Ref muzzle. There we go. Ref muzzle go away. I think I know what's wrong. I think I know why it looks weird, and it's a fundamental thing that's up with the noggin. I feel like her head was in a weird spot. I want her to be facing down still. So I'm gonna see if I can't look a little bit better by actually moving her head. Elongate a little bit. Kind of that. Where's the stupid scarf thing that I put? Torso? Yeah. That does look better. So, tell you what, I am definitely making progress. I'm getting there. I accidentally just turned off my monitor. Pardon me one moment while I turn it back on. There we go. The buttons on the Canvas 13 are interesting because fix the zoom and fix the rotation buttons are right below my turn off my tablet button, and I accidentally did that. So I'll tell you what, I am making good progress. I think I have been at this for too long because I've been trying my best for around 3.5 hours at this point. As I mentioned, I hate sketching, and doing art for too long will make it so you aren't like, you're gonna do worse because you've been staring at the same thing for too long. So I'm gonna stop here, take a break. I'm probably gonna sleep on it. I'll come back and we'll see if we can do more stuff tomorrow.